Okay, chapter...
Harry, I'm gonna abbreviate it.
How it all goes down, is that
Harry
it?
Potter Our civil and the Half-Blood Prince.
H.P.
Whoa.
Yep. H.P. H.Pat...
Chapter 12.
One Saturday morning, Harry tries out a spell scribbled on the margins of his favorite textbook. Immediately, a sleeping Ron across the room is pulled out of his bed and levitates above it, hanging upside down. In the morning, Ron tells Hermione the story of what Harry did to him, which he thinks is hysterical. Hermione, however, doesn't approve. Harry and Hermione bicker about Harry's use of the Half-Blood Prince's textbook. She is not only worried about the ethics of using someone else's textbook, but she is also worried about the danger of the spells and information inside. She says that the prince's spells might not be ministry approved, and the prince seems like a potentially dangerous guy. Later, everyone goes on an outing to Hogsmeade. While on his outing, Harry is confronted by Slughorn, who asks why Harry never comes to any of his parties. Harry blames it on Quidditch practice. Slughorn tries to lock Harry down for another one of his gatherings, but Harry tells him he has an appointment with Dumbledore. Harry sees Mundungus Fletcher outside of the Three Broomsticks Tavern. Fletcher drops a suitcase he is carrying, and the contents spill out. Harry realizes that Fletcher has been pilfering items from Sirius Black's house, now Harry's house, at Grimwald Place. This realization sends Harry into a fury, and he attacks Fletcher, but Fletcher gets away before Harry can do anything. Once inside the tavern, Ron and Hermione try to calm Harry down with some butterbeer, but Harry is... shaken at the thought that someone might be stealing and selling his dead godfather's possessions. Finally, the three decide that they've had enough. They leave the Three Broomsticks and brave the dismal weather, following close behind Katie Bell and her friend. Katie Bell and her friend get into an argument as they are walking. Katie is holding a package. The package falls to the ground and Katie is immediately levitated into the sky, and she is writhing in pain and agony. Below her is an opal necklace peeping through the packaging. Harry runs to again. Harry runs to get Hagrid. Wait. Help, which comes in the form of Hagrid. Hagrid rushes Katie to Hogwarts for medical attention. It would seem someone at the Three Broomsticks, someone used in an imperious court. Katie to control her. Her friend tells Harry that Katie looks all funny when she came out of the bathroom at the tavern, and that she was carrying a mysterious package to someone in Hogwarts. When the package tore open, Katie must have touched the cursed necklace inside of it. Harry realizes that he has seen the necklace before at Borgin and Borks. Borgin and Burks. And he has a feeling Draco has something to do with this whole incident. Harry tells Professor McGonagall his suspicion that Draco was the one who gave Katie the necklace, but McGonagall tells Harry that Draco was anything to do with her during the incident. Harry, Ron, and Hermione hypothesize whom the necklaces were meant for him. Who was the original target?
Racing, I would like that almost completely knocked that freaking drink over.
Oh my god.
The theme of this chapter is confusion because what was that noise? I don't know. Do you know?
Nope, and it's going on.
It's
again
happening
right
now. Lindsay, do you know what it is?
It's probably like some kind of aliens thing. Taking over.
Or that.
There you have it.
The unbreakable vow.